Hey, what's going on, my friends? So today I'm going to walk you through the three-step formula to lose weight sustainably without diet or even eating clean. Okay, so if you're here with me on the live, just drop the word live in the comment. Or if you're here catching the replay, just drop replay so that I know that this training has reached you. All right? Okay, so you see, the typical mainstream weight loss advice you get nowadays is that, you know, when you want to lose weight, you got to go on a diet, you got to eat clean, you got to eat healthy, you know, you got to cut out your carbs, your sugar, right? Then some of you may even try different kinds of, been told that you need to try different kinds of supplements, right? Slimming products and so on. And it makes sense, right? Because you have to do something that is different if you want to get a different result. So what happens is you go on, you try out these methods, right? This diet, and it appears to work at first. You see rapid weight loss at the initial stage. But the only problem with that is it's just not sustainable, mainly due to its restrictive nature. Your entire life is being limited by a set of rules of what you can or you cannot eat. And when you restrict yourself, when you tell yourself that you cannot have a certain kind of food, you start to develop some kind of unnatural cravings, right? Maybe you deprive yourself from having an ice cream or a biscuit, right? And you tell yourself that you cannot have, but the more you tell yourself that you cannot have it, you start to crave for it, and it makes you stress, and as well as impacts your mental health in a bad way. Then what happens? You start to binge, and when you start to binge on this food, you start to feel guilty, right? And you say, I'm going to start all over again. I'm going to try again. So what happens is you start to restrict yourself again. And basically, you are back to square one. And you're repeating the same cycle over and over again, right? First, you restrict. And after that, after you restrict, you have unnatural cravings. Because of the cravings, you start to binge. And after you binge, you start to feel guilty. And once you're having the guilt, you want to go back all over and start again, and you start all over by restricting your food again. So it looks like you notice that you are always been in that never-ending cycle, right? And what I'm going to tell you is that this method, that, you know, what seems to be logically right, is just not realistic and it's not sustainable. Okay, and when you at some point when you stop following the diet, you experience a weight rebound. You go back to where you first started or even regain more weight than before. So understand that this is just a temporary solution which treats the symptoms on the surface, right? Your weight is just treating the weight loss itself. Losing weight itself is just treating the symptoms on the surface. It's not the root cause. And that's like putting a band-aid on a plaster on a bullet wound. Doesn't really make sense, right? But that's what most diets will do for you. And this is what I call, this endless cycle is what I call the yo-yo weight loss trap. Where you're trapped in this endless cycle of losing weight and regaining weight. And it's frustrating, I know, it's tiring, and it's also the main reason why people give up in their weight loss journey. But don't worry, there's a better way. Okay, I'm gonna share with you today. So before that, maybe I just want to check with some of you here if there's something that you can relate to, something that you have experienced before, even right now, right? Like you start to restrict your food, and then after that, you have unnatural cravings. And at some point, you just cannot hold on to yourself and you just binge. And when you binge, you just feel guilty, right? And because of that, you start all over again, right? And because of this, also it makes you stuck in losing weight. I just want to know if that is something that you can relate to or experience. If that's you, just drop a yes in the comments. Okay, and that's okay, right? Because at least you have tried. So be proud of yourself for even trying. And if that's you, you're in the right place today. Because what if I tell you that you did not fail the diet? Okay, whatever diet you have tried in the past, you did not fail the diet. But the diet has failed you. Because eating clean or eating healthy is not the answer. And today I'm going to share with you a new way. This is also what I teach my clients. There's actually a formula to lose weight. And I'm going to show you the three-step formula to lose weight consistently and sustainably. All right, so let's dive into this. Now, whatever you have been trying to lose weight, if it doesn't work, let's not do it again. Okay, so instead of going on another diet, going on and with a set of strict rules, what you want to learn is I'm going to give you something new, which is this time you want to learn to eat right. Not eat less or eat clean or eat healthy, eat right. And eating right is specific to your individual needs, your goals, your needs, and your preference. And here's a three-step formula to help you to implement this right away. Okay, and you can start to lose weight. So the first step is you got to dial into your food portions. And to understand that, I want you to think of it like a financial budget. If you want to be financially well, your income has to be greater than your expenses, right? Because if it's the opposite, you are just going to be broke. Right, so in the same way, our bodies also have this thing called a calorie budget. It's something that is quantifiable, right? It's not about, you know, when we talk about, you know, eating clean or eating healthy, it's not, what does that even mean? There's not something quantifiable. Okay, so you see, back to the financial example, right? It has to be something that is quantifiable, which is your income has to be greater than your expenses. It's not about spending more or spending less. You know, there has to be some calculations involved. Okay, so in the same way, right? When it comes to weight loss, you need to eat lesser calories or portions than you burn in order to lose weight. And I'm just going to show you an example on how you can implement this. Okay, so give me a moment. All right. Okay. So the formula is eat right for weight loss. Okay. So the first step is you have to dial into your food portions for weight loss. And what that means is there are many ways you can do it, right? You can count your calories, you can weigh your food, but to keep things simple, okay, to help you with something that you can implement right away, because counting calories can be something that is more complicated, right? So what we want to learn is just using our hand portion. Okay, so as a general guide, what you want to do is, so you have your protein, your vegetables, your carbs, and your fat. So as a general guide, I want you to start with just 1 to 2 hand portions of each category at each meal. And I assume that you eat three meals a day, okay? So maybe to keep things simple, let's just start with 1 portion per meal and you eat 3 meals a day, okay? And how this works is that, here's an example of how they work, okay? First, you get your protein, then after that, you fill it with vegetables, get some carbs, and lastly, some fats. So if you were to ask me, how about fats, how about oils, right? So I would say one palm is equivalent to one tablespoon of oil. Okay, so that gives you a bit of something. So you see, right now you have something more quantifiable. Okay, like it's not about, so every day you have your hand portion size, right? Because your hand is portable, it's consistent in size. So every day when you use this method, when you're using this method, right, you can be consistent in the amount you are eat. Okay. Now, the second step is you have to eat the right nutrient proportions. How much you eat matters. The type of food you eat, the quality of the food that you eat matters as well. Okay. And this is to nourish your body, to ensure that your metabolism is functioning right and for your overall health. So the guideline here is you want to make sure that at least 80% of your calories come from minimally processed, nutritious whole foods. And it's common for people to, you know, I'm sure that you notice that, you know, when it comes to losing weight, people always like to categorize food as good and bad. Okay, this is what you can have, this is what you cannot have. But unfortunately, this approach, you know, it kind of make the right choices easier. But unfortunately, this also leads to feelings of deprivation, the thing that you have been experiencing. Then you start to crave. And then after that, you binge. And then you're guilty of that. Because we are human beings who can be perfect all the time. Okay, we are not just robots. We are not robots in the sense that if you just give the robot the same thing every day, the robot can take it. But we are humans. So there is a more effective and a more enjoyable way when it comes to food. Instead of seeing them as good and bad, I want you to think of them on a continuum. Okay, let me just put this way. From eat less, eat some, and eat more. Okay, so here's an example of what you can do. I'm just going to share with you. So remember earlier on we talked about, you know, your different sources of food, your protein, your vegetables, your carbohydrates, and then your fats, right? So for protein, these are the list of foods that has been categorized from eat more, eat some, and eat less. And what you want to try, of course, maybe your starting point can be different, right? Maybe right now you're spending most of your time at eat some or eat less. So ideally, what you want to focus on is spend 80% of your time in this column, eat more. Okay. And over time, your goal is simple. Aim to progress up the continuum from choosing more of the eat more and eat some options and fewer from the eat less options. Okay. So right now, maybe you're spending more time in this eat some and eat less in the yellow and the red. So as the weeks goes by, you want to shift from these two columns, the yellow and red, to green and yellow. And eventually, if you want to be, you want to take it to a more advanced level, you can just focus on the green column. Okay. Let me just pause here to see if there's any questions or comments. All right. In the same way, applies to carbohydrates as well. All right. And I won't go into the details of the food. It's something that you can have a look. So what you want to do is basically is to learn to build your own meal plate like this, based on the list of food that is given, your protein, your carbohydrates, and fats. And lastly, we also have fats. Okay, it's the same thing. And here's one thing I want to touch is that your vegetables, your fruits and vegetables, I usually categorize them under this column, which is eat the rainbow. So what you want to do is you want to get a variety of fruits and vegetables into your diet, because different colors would mean different nutrients and health benefits. Okay, so every day, what you can try to aim for is two to three different colors of fruits and vegetables. So give you an example, right? Maybe for lunch you have a pumpkin and a green vegetable. So there you go, you already have your orange and your green. And maybe as for fruits, you have an apple, so you have a red. So that's how, it's an example of how you can get three different colors a day. And of course, you don't have to get five different colors a day, all right? So what you want to do is to learn to rotate between two to three different colors a day, okay? But if you're just starting out, if you just choose to stick with one color as a start, that's fine also. All right, don't allow the idea of, you have to be perfect to stop you from taking any action. All right, just pick maybe one to two different kinds and just go with it. And the last thing is, okay, based on the food choices that I've shown you, right? The third step of this formula is you want to eat foods that works with your body, not against it. Okay, it's very important to include foods of your preference or foods you enjoy, and this allows you to have some flexibility in life instead of following a rigid or strict diet that is not sustainable. Okay, because if you are happy with what you eat, you can be consistent and it will be sustainable for you for the rest of your life. Because like I said, we are humans, we are not robots. Our life are complex. We have emotions, we have social life that we need to attend to. And going on strict diets can make it challenging for us to participate in this aspect of life, right? Imagine if your close friend, your family needs to go out and eat, but you're not allowed to eat out or eat certain food because of some restrictions or some strict diet that you are on. Wouldn't that lead to unnecessary stress and frustration? So don't make life harder than it already is. Okay, so it's important to pick it's important to pick foods that you enjoy, which is why I give you a list of choices of food that you can pick. So the whole idea is to lose weight is not about following a diet, a particular set of diet that was given by someone, right? What you want to, the goal of to build a sustainable weight loss diet is to build a diet, to learn to eat, to learn to build a meal plate that is sustainable for you. Something that you can do consistently. Okay, something that you enjoy to eat. Okay, and I just want to share with you a fun fact. Do you know that the origin of the word diet comes from the Greek word dieta, and it means a way of life? It's not just something you do to lose weight, it's a way of life. So when you are building this, when you follow these three steps, right, what you're actually doing is you're creating a new way of life to help you to lose weight and sustain it, because all foods can be part of your diet. Okay, but the key here is to find a way of eating that allows you to lose weight and allows you to feel and perform at your best, as well as something that you can stick with consistently for the rest of your life. So if you like certain foods, do include them into your diet. If you don't like certain foods, maybe someone tell you that broccoli is good, but if you hate it, there's no reason to eat it. The only foods that you shouldn't eat is the foods that you don't enjoy eating. Okay, and you don't have to eat it. Okay, and here's one last key I wanted to share with you, which is how you lose weight will be similar to how you live your life. If your method or your diet, the way of eating is sustainable, your results will be maintainable. And that is key. And here are some examples of what I do personally. Okay, this is my meal plate. Okay, on how I build my own diet based on this three-step formula. So as you can see, I have two pieces of protein here, two servings of protein, two servings of vegetables, and based on my hand size, it's about 1.5 serving of. All right, so depending on your hand size, your plate will look, the size of your plate or your meal plate will be different. Okay, you just have to adjust accordingly. Okay, so and why the reason why I share this method is that it still allows you to have some flexibility. And currently right now, if you're just starting out, you may not have time or the energy to prepare your meals. And you to lose weight, you know, you don't need to change your diet completely overnight. You know, I'm still eating out, right? But just adjust your current food portions accordingly. And most importantly, you stick with it. Because you're not going to lose weight within 1 or 2 days of following this method. Okay, at least give yourself like 2 weeks, 3 weeks before making any adjustments. Most people do go on a diet. I mean, they all try, they hop on a program, they do for 2 or 3 days or even a week, and they don't see results, then they quit. But in truth is, you need to give it a bit of time. Okay, it can be 2 weeks, can be even up to 3 weeks. All right. And just an important note I want to share here is that whatever the portion numbers that I've shared is just a starting point. It's not the ending point. It's not absolutes. Okay, because we have to adjust. So how fast you can lose body fat is kind of depends on how consistent you are. And understand that fat loss is often faster at the start when you have more fat to lose. And as you become more lean, as you lose more weight, the slower the rate will become. Right, and is normal. And with that in mind, you are likely to have to make some adjustments. But first, for now, I just want to share with you what kind of progress that is possible. Sorry. Or reasonable, right? So a realistic fat loss goal or weight loss goal is to lose 0.5 to 1% of body weight per week. So if you're someone who weighs 100 kilos now, if every week you can lose 0.5 kilo to 1 kilo a week, that is great progress. Okay. All right. And yeah, if you like this, have a copy of this 3-step formula guide, just comment guide to get it. And I want to share with you some examples of clients that have been using this formula to lose weight. So this is an example of Lavan. So he has lost 10 kilos and flattened his stomach within 3 months, within 90 days. So before he started with me, he was classified as a class 1 obese. He was low energy, was tired most of the time. And basically, he did what everyone else did while we're trying to lose weight. You go on a diet. And the result, as you know, that is just not sustainable. So after being in the program, 3 months, he go from obese, he lost about 10 kilos. Right now, he's fit, he's energetic, he's healthy. And while the best part is, whilst you're eating foods he loves. Because this is so important, right? I mean, what works, the food that works can help me to lose weight does not mean what necessarily will be able to help him to lose weight. And same goes for you. So that is why that is why it's so important to learn to build your own meal plan. And this 3-step formula is going to help you to achieve that. Okay? And not just this formula is not just applied for someone like for Lavan or myself. It also applied to many other of our clients. Okay. So they have lost pretty significant amount of weight. They got rid of their belly fat and yeah. Okay. So just to do a quick recap. So if they can do it, you can do it as well. Okay, it's not something that is super complicated, but you just need the right approach, the right formula to do it. Okay, and to recap the three-step formula to eat right for weight loss is, the first step is you got to dial into your food portions for weight loss. The second step is you have to eat the right nutrient proportions. And the third step is eat foods that works with your body and not against it. All right. So let me just come back here. Yeah, so I hope this gives you a new perspective and hope, because your weight loss goals, your fitness goals is really within your reach. It's really not rocket science. It does not have to be complicated where you need to count your calories, you need to only eat a certain kind of food and stuff like that. It's, for a start, it's actually very simple and anyone can learn and implement right away. Like after this training, you can just, if you want a document, just drop the word guide in the comment and I'll send it to you. You can implement this right away into your next meal. And all you need is actually the right approach. Okay. So far, I think this is the most effective way of eating to lose weight consistently and in a sustainable way. I've done this for years. I've helped many other men to do the same. And I believe I also would love to help you achieve the same as well. Okay. So hope you find this training helpful. And if you want more help, okay, you want extra support to help you to lose weight, we can even work on a personalized weight loss plan for you. Okay, so what we're going to do is let's have a chat about your goals, your challenges, and see how I can possibly help you on that if you're interested. So we got to figure out what is actually holding you back and provide you with the necessary tools and approaches for your specific situation, right? And basically it boils down to three main things, right? The first thing is you got to learn to eat right to lose weight, which is what we have covered. The next thing is we have to implement some progressive weight training routine into your life to help you work out, to help you to build strength, to build muscle, and to boost your metabolism. And the third thing is we have to install fit mindset and habits into your life. Because it's one thing to lose weight, it's another thing to maintain your weight loss. Okay, if you want to be fit, to be healthy, it all begins with your mindset and your habits. And these are the things that, if you think about it, whatever things that got you to where you are here today is your mindset and habits. So where you want to be in your future is, you got to change. If you want to have a different future, you want to change your life, you have to change your mindset and habits. That's where we will talk about how do we plan, how do we create routines, how do we build certain habits, right, that you can do in your everyday life. Okay, and one important thing to know that is that you want to learn how to implement this new sustainable lifestyle wherever you are. Okay, once you lose weight, losing weight is just the first part. What you want to do is, what's more important is for you to be able to sustain your weight loss. Okay, and that's what we want to help you to do as well. And when you do it right, you'll be surprised by how simple and quick you can actually get the results that you want. It's not as many of my clients at the end of the day, they say it's actually not as scary or as hard as they thought it would be. Okay, all you need is the right tools. Okay, so if it's something that you're interested, okay, you want to get some help, just send me a private message. Maybe just send me a private message with the word plan, and let's have a chat. All right, so that's all I have for today. Hope you found value from today's training. I appreciate all of you who is tuning into this training. And as always, stay healthy, happy, and have an amazing day ahead.